Browser extensions like for Google Chrome can be extremely useful. I have a whole bunch myself. But this video is a warning that you need to be extremely diligent when going and installing new ones, even if you're getting them from the official Chrome Web Store. There have been countless stories of malicious extensions slipping through on the Chrome Web Store and being installed by millions of people. And in my opinion, Google does not do nearly enough to vet these extensions, and really their vetting process is not reliable at all, in my opinion. There are even extensions like this one that were installed by malware, and literally every single review is people saying they can't remove it, how it's a virus, they don't want this extension, yet this thing has remained on the web store for over 6 months. And there are some nasty extensions out there recently that even have come from advertisements on Facebook and then would hack your Facebook account and take it over by stealing your credentials. But spoiler alert, those are something that the sponsor of this video, Guardio, can protect against. I'll get to that later. So in this video, I'll go over things like various types of malicious extensions and ways they're installed and some tricks they use to prevent being uninstalled, and of course, some ways you can avoid these extensions, or at least minimize your risk. So what are some ways that a malicious extension might get installed in the first place? And the first one is it may be on the Chrome Web Store itself. And a lot of times what these will do is they'll pretend to be one thing, or they may even do that simple task that they advertise as, but then they'll do something malicious in the background. They may ask for way more permissions than is necessary for that task, and people will grant them, and then you don't even realize that in addition to that thing, it's doing a whole bunch of other nasty stuff. Here's one example of an extension whose only purpose is to redirect your searches to some crappy random search engine, so basically they can display ads to you. And there's a couple reviews, but they're basically gibberish. You can tell these are fake reviews. But there are other examples of ones that did a lot more nasty stuff, like fake ChatGPT extensions that pretended to give you ChatGPT access, but then they would literally steal your tokens for your cookies and hijack your Facebook account, change your account name, use it for God knows what. And these were on the Chrome Web Store, but it wasn't until they got quite a bit of attention before Google finally removed them. Now, on this topic of protecting against malicious extensions, we have a very relevant sponsor for today, Guardio. Guardio provides real-time, enterprise-level protection from all sorts of threats while browsing the web, including the malicious extensions I'm talking about today, and all the while still being affordable to consumers and small businesses. For example, Guardio scans your browser extensions and alerts you if there are any disguised malicious extensions installed and disables them. In fact, they were the ones that first discovered the fake ChatGPT extensions and reported on that. So they're actually being proactive in searching for new malicious extensions. They then fingerprint and block those extensions like you can see here. It will warn you, and even if it gets installed some other way, it will be immediately disabled. But that's not all. Guardio also blocks malicious websites using in-house custom developed methods for detecting phishing and malware content, all before those threats even have a chance to do any harm. Guardio has also added download protection to block malicious files even if you accidentally download them, like from fake sites for popular software or even malicious game mods. One of my other favorite features is Guardio will also warn you if a website's domain has been registered very recently, which is a major red flag. You can scan your browser for threats for free by visiting guard.io/theojo and installing the extension, and you'll also get a 7-day free trial to the premium features such as real-time threat removal. Plus, you'll even get 20% off every month of the first year of their affordable premium plan for full protection. So if you want a clean and secure browsing experience, again, visit guard.io/theojo, link in the description. And with all that being said, let's continue. Another way a malicious extension might be installed is by malware. So you might download a free package of some kind of software from some sketchy website, and it might even be that legitimate software, but along with it is packaged a sketchy installer that also installs an extension. You used to see this kind of thing a lot where you download some free program, and if you didn't uncheck a certain box during the installation process, it would install some kind of toolbar. Same idea, but the range of how malicious these might be could vary greatly. If you're lucky, the extension is easily removable, just like any other. You just go and click to remove it. But there are some times where the malware may change management policies on your computer for Google Chrome, where you literally won't be able to uninstall it in the normal way, because it'll say managed by your administrator, you can't uninstall this because it was installed by an admin, that sort of thing. And sometimes they'll even add a way for it to reinstall itself even if you do remove it, like by adding scheduled tasks to the task scheduler in Windows, and if you remove it every day, it'll just reinstall it. Now, to be clear, if you see managed by organization, you don't necessarily have to be worried. It is a legitimate feature, and it may, for example, show up if you have certain antiviruses. They will manage the browser and implement policies and stuff. And also, if you are using a work device or a work account, a lot of times companies will implement certain company-wide settings on the browsers as requirements, or also required extensions if you're gonna be using a company device, that sort of thing. So really, you only have to be worried if you know that you have a malicious extension that's using this method to prevent it from being uninstalled. But anyway, an example of this is that one I showed you before where people are saying they literally cannot uninstall it even though they want to. Now, the fact that Google hasn't removed this one is astounding to me. I guess maybe they're saying, well, all it does is, you know, change someone's search browser like it says. It's not doing anything it doesn't say it does, but ignoring the fact that it's a virus that is the only thing that's installing this. No one is voluntarily installing this, so they should remove it. Now, moving on, a third way that a extension could be installed is what it's called sideloaded or manually installed. So you don't have to install stuff from the Chrome Web Store. If you enable developer mode in the extensions page, you can actually install a Chrome extension using a file just like any other program on your computer. So a lot of times malware will install an extension this way to totally bypass the Chrome Web Store because it might be doing something so obviously malicious that it would get caught on there, but with this, it doesn't get checked at all, so that's a common way they'll do it. Now, as for different categories of malicious extensions and what they do, I mean, really, the sky's the limit. They can be just as malicious as any other malware or virus on your computer. Because if you think about it, a lot of times, if you download a virus, they're targeting stuff you're doing on the internet anyway, like keylogging, password logins, stuff like that. So if they can get that done with an extension, they may as well. One example I mentioned before are search hijackers. So they'll just replace your default search engine with some random one so that they can get that ad revenue if you go and use it. Another one might be ad injectors, where they'll actually modify a website to add in additional ads, which obviously the revenue will go to the creator of the malicious extension, so they'll make money that way. I've also seen examples of crypto mining Chrome extensions that do that in the background without you knowing. And at the high end of being nasty, you have stuff like keyloggers and cookie stealing extensions. And by cookie stealing, I mean that if you log into a website, it adds a cookie to your browser so it keeps you logged in. Well, the malware may steal that cookie and send it to the creator of the malware, and then they are already logged into your account and they don't even have to worry about typing in the password or two-factor authentication. It's a really easy way for them to steal accounts. Or, of course, these extensions could do multiple or all of the above. There's one example of a really bad campaign called Dormant Colors, where there was like 30 different extensions that were all color and theme related for your browser. And on the surface, they actually did what they said and they remained dormant. And there was actually malicious code hidden in there. And it wasn't until they had millions of installs where they activated the malicious part. And they did stuff like replacing search engines, replacing URLs that you type in to redirect to a phishing version of a website, all sorts of nasty stuff. And there's at least one example of them getting a featured badge, which usually means that it was vetted by an actual person on the Chrome Web Store team. And I guess at that point, there's not really much you can do about it. If you see that, you should think it's trusted, but who knows? Now, there are several things you can do to avoid a lot of these malicious extensions. Some of them are more common sense, some of them not. One thing you could do is check to see if it has a lot of installs. And obviously, this is not a guarantee, but it's kind of a signal because you would think if it really was malicious, the more people that use it, the more likely that there'd be people that are reporting it as malicious. But also watch out because I suspect that install count can be botted. I mean, this extension has showing over 300,000 installs, but I mean, there's just two obviously fake reviews. It just doesn't add up. So maybe see if the number of reviews versus installs makes sense. Next, you can check to see what badges are on the Chrome extension, but again, these are not necessarily any kind of guarantee at all. But one of them is this established publisher badge. It just has a check mark next to the website. This doesn't really seem to be very meaningful. I believe this just means they verified their website and that they don't have any current violations on their developer account, but I mean, they could easily verify any website they sign up for. That doesn't really mean anything. And they could just mean they weren't caught yet if they don't have any violations. And obviously, if they are, they're just going to make a new one. So just from them having this badge, I wouldn't really consider that anything of importance. But if it is tied to a well-known website, like a really well-known company or something, that might be meaningful because it means they actually are associated with that website. Another badge to look for is the featured badge. This one should theoretically mean that it is safe because apparently it is actually reviewed by the Chrome Web Store team, and you know, they reviewed it, made sure it follows policies, and deemed it good. So I would say generally I would trust an extension that is featured, but again, there was that one from the Dormant Colors campaign that ended up being malicious that was featured, but like I said, really at that point there's not really much you can do if even the Chrome Web Store employees can't figure that out. You can also check the reviews. Obviously, if it has a lot of negative reviews, that's not a good sign. And you can also maybe look at how old the oldest review is to see how long this extension has been around, most likely. If it's a very new extension, I probably wouldn't trust it as much as one that's been there for years, because there's no way to see actually when a Chrome extension was first published. It just shows you the most recent update. So looking at the oldest review is probably the only decent way to do that. Another thing to look out for is if the Chrome extension claims to be part of some open source project or something that's popular, make sure that you look at the website that it links to and ensure that it is actually associated with that project, and make sure that website links back to that actual extension. Because with the fake ChatGPT extensions, they pretended to be part of a popular open source Chrome extension that was legitimate, but they weren't actually associated with that. So you would have had to want to go to that actual GitHub page and make sure that it was linking to that correct one. But the tricky thing is, these fake ChatGPT extensions were actually being advertised on Google search sponsor results and Facebook ads, so really being pushed out there. This is actually something that the sponsor of this video, Guardio, actually discovered and did a bunch of research on. I can put links to their articles in the description, and that's where I got these diagrams too. Finally, one thing you can do is go into the Chrome settings and security and enable the enhanced protection mode, which apparently has some kind of way of checking if an extension is trusted by Google, though I couldn't really find any explanation of how they determine what makes an extension trusted or not. It says that after a few months, an extension or a developer should be considered trusted, I guess if it goes long enough without getting flagged or anything. But there are extensions like this one that are fine, that have been around for years, that still say untrusted when it gets installed, and it doesn't even tell you why, which is the confusing thing. Now, it does say untrusted for one of the search hijacking extensions, but for the other one, it does not. So again, it's not a guarantee, but it's just maybe one more layer of security. If you'd rather be safe, just don't install anyone that doesn't say it's trusted, just knowing that it's possible that it could be flagging some that are fine. Finally, we can go over how to remove one of these extensions if you have one installed. Like I said, if you're lucky, you can uninstall it just like any other Chrome extension, but just be aware if you go into the extensions page, they may have named the extension something misleading or very vague. And what I mean is, it might be a search hijacking extension, but it may be called something like security extension or image resizer. I just made those up, but it could be literally anything. Therefore, basically just look for ones that may be related to what it's doing or ones you don't remember installing. If you're unlucky, then you may have had malware that installed this extension and specifically made it hard to remove. And there's a few ways they can do that. Usually it involves creating a management policy in your Chrome extension that prevents you from being able to uninstall it. One way they can do this is by modifying the registry keys, because Chrome has registry keys that can be used for policy management. Also, if you're on Windows 10 or 11 Pro, they could have used the group policy editor policies to add one for Chrome to do the same thing. And on top of that, they may have added a scheduled task to reinstall itself even if you do uninstall it. And of course, you can't discount the possibility that the malware is still installed and running on your computer too. Now, as for getting around this policy management trick, you can go and delete the stuff manually, but there is one person, a product expert on the Google Chrome community forums, who created a policy remover batch file. The person's name is Stefan VD, and I'll put a link to this post in the description, and you can just download that batch file. I looked through it. Basically, what the batch file does is it will first close Google Chrome from running, obviously. It will then delete any group policy folders in System32. So just be aware, if you're running Windows Pro and you have any group policy set, it will probably erase that. It also deletes some policy folders in the Chrome program files installation directory. And it also looks like it deletes some registry entries related to Google Chrome. So theoretically, that should allow you to go and uninstall the extension. But again, you might want to check the task scheduler, especially if you notice it reinstalls itself, and just kind of look through there. And I don't know what it would be called. You're just gonna have to literally look through these all and look on the right hand side. You can also click on each one and on the bottom of the window, go to the actions tab for each one, and that will tell you what each action is actually doing. Usually if a virus adds a task like this, they'll name it something innocuous to hide what it actually is doing. So it might say something Google Chrome related or maybe not. Though I did find one article with an example where the task pointed to a PowerShell script like this, and it was named Microsoft Windows Optimizer Update. So looks like you'll have to look for ones that have PowerShell scripts too. And this one actually got into the System32 directory, which is really bad. That means it had admin access, which could definitely mean the virus is still there. Here's another malicious task example where the whole PowerShell command is within the task itself. It doesn't reference a PowerShell script file. This one was created by malware called BlazeLoader, and it was actually used to reinstall a malicious extension known as Safe Browsing Extension. Just be aware that there are some legitimate Google Chrome update tasks in there, but I guess you'll just have to figure that out yourself. Anyway, after you deal with that, like I said, you can go to the extensions page, hopefully find it and remove it, or you could just reset Google Chrome settings, which should disable all extensions. So you can do that by going into the settings and then reset settings and then restore settings to the original defaults, and you see that it says it will disable extensions. And like I said, you should probably do an antivirus scan as well, and maybe look back at some software that you may have downloaded recently that could have came along with that virus. If I think of anything else though, I'll add that to the description. So you might want to look there if that doesn't work for you, or let me know in the comments if it works one way or another so I can know. But yeah, hopefully that should shed some light on something that you didn't really know was a risk. And next time you go to install some extensions, you'll do some double checking first. Thanks again to Guardio for sponsoring this video. It's the best way to avoid installing all those malicious extensions. So be sure to visit guard.io/TheoJoe to do a free scan and detect if you have any harmful extensions installed already. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to give it a big thumbs up for my YouTube algorithm overlords. And again, let me know down in the comments if this enlightened you or maybe helped you remove an extension that was malicious. If you want to keep watching, the next video I'd recommend is one where I was talking about a whole bunch of different hidden Chrome menus for settings and stuff that you probably never seen before. So I'll put that link right there. You can just click on. So thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.